Hello everyone, in this video tutorial I will show you how to make a glass bowl using few modifiers in Blender. This is the default view that is displayed when Blender starts. We need to go to front orthographic view. For that, press key 1 followed by key 5 on your numpad, or you can also go to view menu, select front and then orthographic view. Switch to edit mode by pressing tab key once. Press X and select vertices to delete the cube. What we now need to do is place the vertices in a way that resembles the edge of a bowl. For that, press and hold down the control key and using the left mouse button, drop the vertices on the desired places. Now switch to object mode by pressing the tab key. This somewhat resembles the edge of a bowl. While in object mode, go to modifiers tab and select screw modifier. We get a shape of a bowl. Now go to modifiers tab and select solidify modifier and give it a thickness of about 0.1. Again go to modifiers tab and select subdivision surface and change the view value to 2. We now need to refine the shape of our bowl. And for that, again switch to edit mode by pressing tab key and also change viewport shading as wireframe. Select and adjust the vertices as per the required shape. This screw modifier works around the origin. So when you zoom in on the object, you will find a hole at the bottom. To overcome this problem, after getting satisfied with the shape, apply all the modifiers to change the object into a mesh. Go to edit mode and using the rectangular select tool by pressing B key, select all the vertices. Press Alt plus M and merge all the vertices at the center. I will now scale the size of the bowl to its half. For that, press S key, type 0.5 and then press enter. We now need to add a plane for this bowl to rest upon. Press Shift A and select plane. To scale the size, press S, type 10 followed by enter. We now need to set a camera in the scene. For that, press N to enable property shelf, select lock camera to view. Press key 0 on the numpad to switch to camera view. Align the view in the camera window. We now need to set up materials and lighting. For that, I like to use Cycles render engine. To set up the lighting, switch to top view by pressing key 7 on the numpad, grab the lamp and move to the center. Now switch to front view, zoom out of the scene and move the lamp in front of the camera. Now switch to right view by pressing key 3 on the numpad and move the lamp along the y-axis in front of the camera. We now need to set up the parameters for the lamp. For that, click on the object data button. We will be using point lamp. Set the size to 5. Click on use notes button and set the strength to 2000. We now need to set up the materials. For that, select the bowl, go to Materials tab, click Use Nodes, select the surface type as Glass BSDF and I will give it a slight bluish tint. Now select Plane, click on New. I will use the default settings for the plane. Now switch to camera view by pressing key 0 on the numpad. And to get a view of the scene, select viewport shading as rendered. The rendered viewport gives the brief idea of the scene. We see that the world background is set to gray. To change the color, go to World tab, click on Use Nodes and set the desired color. I will be using blue color of the sky. We are now ready to create the final render of the scene. Switch to solid viewport and save the project in case anything goes wrong while rendering. Click on camera button in the properties panel. Set the render samples to about 2000 in the sampling section. Higher the samples, greater is the quality, but longer it will take to render. Set the clamp indirect value to 1. This will help eliminate the fireflies, that is the noisy white colored pixels in the image. After making all the selections, click on the render button. This image is going to take some time, so I will pause the video while rendering. This image took about 37 minutes for my system to render. To save the image, go to Image menu, click Save As, enter the file name, choose the directory and save the image. This now concludes the tutorial. If you liked watching the video, do subscribe and leave a comment. Thanks for watching.